Hello, friends. Jim Nantz along with Phil Simms. It always gets ratcheted up, the intensity, that is, when you got a divisional matchup at your hands, as we do today.
Well, you know it's an exciting time of year, or it's a different time of the year. When practice is over, you go in there, and there's about 20 times more reporters at your locker than there was the week before. So that gets you fired up, Jim, makes you even pay more attention in meetings, and I think makes the football game a lot better.
Okay, let's head down to the field now for the start of this one. And he'll start his return. He stacked up at that point. Here's the man who in 2011 set the NFL's single season pass yardage record, quarterback Drew Brees.
Drew Brees, even though he's 6'1", he plays so much taller. Look at him. He has long arms, big hands, stands very tall when he throws the football. One of the reasons why he is spectacular when it comes to throwing the football from the pocket.
They come to the line of scrimmage. First down. Running back gets it on the handoff. That brings the play to an end.
When you look at the Saints lineup, you got to look at tight end. Jimmy Graham, a player to watch.
Jimmy Graham's covered. Remember, he's not covered. He's open. Throw it to him no matter what. The guy can maneuver his size, his hands. He has all that you need. He can make the catch in a lot of tough situations.
Second down. Five-step drop. The throw to the left. The tackle was made, but the first down is picked up.
Nice job by the offense picking up that first down here to start the game, and that is important to give you a little confidence, to give you some rhythm, and most of all, just release some of that pressure you feel.
What is it about Drew Brees that you admire so much at quarterback?
Drew Brees is a tremendous athlete. He's 6'1", and if people always see his height, but they forget to look at the other things. He has the arm length of a guy 6'5". He has hands of an NBA player. He was a great tennis player growing up. So all that athletic ability and those traits that I just told you about, that's just some of the reasons why he has success on the field.
Second down here.
Now the defensive line is shifting to the right.
Quarterback dropping back, looking to get the feet planted. And Sean Weatherspoon makes the hit.
Sometimes you got to give the coaches credit. They design a play that's smart, easy for the players to manage. And what we got there is a throw and a catch. And now they have a pretty good chance of getting a first down.
First down coming up
from the shotgun.
And he's taken down.
The name of the game is hit the guy with the football. The quarterback has it. The defensive end, what a job by him. Gets by the tackle and sacks the QB.
If you were a defensive coordinator and you knew you had to face Drew Brees, what would you think?
Tackle well, because everything comes into play. He can find one receiver to the next as fast as anybody in the NFL. And no matter what defense you're in, they know how to change the plays to get to the right one that's going to work the best against what you're doing. That's why he's had such, like you said, Jim, Hall of Fame success.
They hand it off to the running back.
The 23 with the carry. Gain of 5.
Play number 6 coming up on this drive. Third down and 13. Looking for a receiver on the left side here. And he's going to be tackled, and that's going to bring us to fourth down.
Good job by the defense. They're well taught, well schooled by the defensive coordinator. They know in situations like this, if it's thrown short of the first down marker, they're good. They come up, make the tackle. Now we have fourth down.
They're set to punt it away now. That's a touchback, and the ball will be spotted at the 20. Here's the former Boston College quarterback, Matt Ryan.
Size is a talent when you talk about quarterbacks in this league, and Matt Ryan, every bit of 6'5", and he plays tall, stands tall. One of the reasons why he has success.
Falcons come onto the field for their next series. First down on the way. Turner, middle. That'll stop the play right there. Hey, Phil, looking at these lineups, Julio Jones and the Atlanta Falcons, what a threat he is.
Yeah, he is. You know what it makes me think of when I see Julio Jones? Why didn't the University of Alabama throw it to him more? He's got everything too, Jim. You got to find ways to get the football in his hands and let him make some plays.
After the 2-yard carry, it sets up second down and 8.
Number 33 on the carry.
The defensive line will be the focus here in this game. If they're disrupting the quarterback, the rest of the defense will have a chance to do their thing. Minutes down, 45 minutes to go. And we'll return after this message and a word from your local station. Following the run, it's now 3rd and 7. Throwing now to his left. He steps out.
What a job by the quarterback, finding a way to throw that football and pick up another first down. They are marching down the field right now.
Here's the first snap after the big play. Michael Turner takes the handoff.
Well, this team is definitely committed to the run. There's no doubt about it. And when you're committed to the running game, hey, a lot of them are not going to work. That's okay. Stay with it.
It's now 2nd down and 7 after the 3-yard rush. Another handoff. And he's knocked out of bounds.
A lot of ways to get plays in the NFL. It doesn't always have to be by a pass. Good job that time by the running back.
New set of downs now after picking up the first on the ground. He's in the clear. They bring him down at the 29-yard line.
When you're going against a really...